Hello friends, welcome to this new coding tutorial. As I got many questions about the source code I have published on GitHub, I will create short videos like this one where I can give more details on the solution I presented. Today, we will see how to use a simple donut plot for logistic continuous improvement. I have used this visual for a video and a series of articles related to the design of an automated supply chain control tower using Python. The idea is to connect to different systems to build a solution to track the shipment along the distribution network of a fashion retail company. After connecting to the different systems, you can get timestamp for each step of the shipment delivery. What is interesting is that you can measure the actual timestamps for each process and compare them with the target. If you have late shipments, so the actual delivery date is after the target delivery date, you can then look at each of the intermediate timestamp to see where your shipment got delays. You will create late delivery reason code. For instance, if your shipment left the warehouse too late, you can then put the reason code warehouse. The idea of the visual that you see here is to show the split of delayed shipments by reason code. We will use a donut plot that is basically an evolved version and more aesthetic in my opinion of the pie plot. Let's see how we can build this chart. I first start by importing the needed libraries. So here I will only need pandas and matplotlib. Then I add some additional visual setting for the Jupyter notebook. So here I'm wrapping the data frame and I'm increasing the number of rows and columns that we can show. And then I start importing the data that we'll need to plot. So what we can see here is that we have 10,000 order lines. The next step is to set the day of extraction. Indeed, what I want to simulate is a planning manager that is performing this kind of request on a daily basis. So, and depending on the day, the results will be different. So that's why we need to put this parameter. So here, based on the data frame, I will put the 11th of May. And then what we need, what is extremely important, is to convert it to date time and keep only the date format. Okay, the next step is, now that we have the date, is we need to filter the data frame. Indeed, what we want to see is the shipment delivered and the shipment delivered late. So we need to filter first the shipment delivered and then add another filter for the late delivered. So I will create another data frame called late. And what I will do, I will take the initial one and I will first get the delivered shipment. So the delivered shipments are the one with the status delivery time. So it should be good. And then I add another condition. So here I want the late delivered. So the late delivered basically are the one that have a reason code that is not null. So if you go here, I think it's at the end, you have a reason code. So for instance, the first one is a delivered shipment that has a reason code multi. So that means it has multiple reasons why it's late. And here you can see it's late. If you look at this one, for instance, it's not late. So that, and you can see that it doesn't have a reason code. So actually, if we filter by the reason code, we are sure that we are taking the late delivered. So here I will remove the one that don't have. I will copy. And then what I need to do is to group them. To group them by reason code to count them, because the donut plot will show you the split by reason code. So I'll do group by. So here I will group by reason code and I will count. So here what I will do, I will count the shipment number and I will take the unique. So normally you have one shipment number per line, but just in case, I will take the unique one and then I want to show it. Okay, so this will be the data that we need to plot our donut plot. We are going to draw the hole, which will be basically a white circle. So, circle. So, white circle. Here we can call it hole. So, when we remember why we are making it. So, first, I think we need to put the origin. So, here it will be at the center. We need to put the radius. So, here we'll put 0.8. And then after we can play with it to see what would be the impact. And the color is white. And then you are just plotting a normal pie plot. So we take in a df late plot pie. We'll put the figure size 8.8, should be okay. First I need to see to select the column. So here is a shipment without S. I don't want the legend. The font size, we take 40. The color map. So the color map paired. I use always this one. Auto percentage for the formatting. I will take that one if I remember well. So if there is an error, that means there is only one percentage. And then I like to add this feature called explode. That's the one that puts some white space between the different chunk of the donut. And here you need to put as many as you have columns. So here we have 5 columns, so we need 5. And then after we can play with it to see what could be the impact if you change this parameter. Then we're good, pat.title. So I will add the title. So I will count the number of shipments delivered with delay by reason code. And then I will add the number of total shipments. So here maybe I can add end shipments equals df. So here you take late and you count the total shipment. Okay. Then okay, great. Maybe I will add a font size so it's more clear. Equals 14. Did I miss anyone? No, that's good. I remove the axis. So I usually do for the pie plot. And then we need to add the circle. So we take the current plot, right, and we add, use this function to add the circle. So here, my circle. And then we can show. Shipment, a comma, forgotten. Did I forget anyone? No, things should be good. So here we have the results. If we remove the circle, so I don't know if I comment this line, it's a pipeline. Okay. Now let's play a bit with the radius. What if I put 95? You see, like it's thinner and actually more elegant, I would say. And what if I put 05? Yeah, it's more bagel than a donut. So let's keep 95. And then the last thing I wanted to show you is the explode. So first, let me come back to the initial one. Okay. And then if I explode to the first column, so normally it's the delivery that will be impacted. So you see, like the chunk is bigger and you have more space. So we can tweak with these different parameters to change the aesthetic of your graph. I hope everything was clear enough, but if you have any question, feel free to let them in the comment section.